हेलो, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। हाउ आर यू
सब
समीर, समीक्षा, स्टीव? ओके, माजन, यू आर ट्रेंडिंग योर फर्स्ट क्लास, राइट? हेलो।
यस, दिस माय फर्स्ट क्लास।
ओके, सो माजन, वी वर एक्चुअली डूइंग द सेकेंड चैप्टर इन द माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स, एंड आई हैव टेकन वन क्लास ऑफ दिस चैप्टर ना। आई हैव कवर्ड सेशन ऑफ कंज्यूमर इक्विलिब्रियम, वेर एन आई हैव बेसिकली एक्सप्लेन्ड द वेरी बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ कंज्यूमर इक्विलिब्रियम, लाइक हु इज अ कंज्यूमर, वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम, एंड वॉट इज एक्चुअली कंज्यूमर्स इक्विलिब्रियम, something like this. Okay, so we'll first revise everything, whatever I have taught you in the last session. Only then we will proceed further. Give me a minute, guys. Okay. See, in the last session, I have told you that consumer is basically a person who consumes the good or services for the satisfaction of his want. Any person who consume any good or uses basically any services, avail any services, is a consumer. And there is basically a difference between customer and consumer. Sometimes we get confused between customer. Customer is basically a person who chases the good, who pays for the good, but consumer is a person who consumes the good, irrespective of whether he have make payment for it or not. A person can be a consumer. All right. For being a consumer, the only thing which is important is that consumer must consume the good or avail any kind of services. All right. Then I have told you that equilibrium is basically a situation of maximum satisfaction. Equilibrium refers to a situation where a person is maximum satisfied. Then I have covered the meaning of consumer equilibrium, and I have told you that a consumer's equilibrium is basically a situation where a consumer spends his income in such a way that he is getting maximum amount of satisfaction or from any good or services. Now, I have told you that there are basically two approaches to understand the entire concept of equilibrium, and those concepts are basically given by two different economists. One was Professor Alfred Marshall, and the other economist was J.R. Hicks and Allen. So both of these economists gave their different theories for consumer equilibrium. They basically, Alfred Marshall have given a theory which is called utility theory or utility approach, and J.R. Hicks and Allen have given his own theory regarding the consumer's equilibrium. So basically, consumer equilibrium, if you consider the approaches of consumer equilibrium, so there are two of consumer's equilibrium. One is as per the Professor Alfred Marshall, and the other one is according to J.R. Hicks and Allen. And Alfred Marshall basically gave the theory which is called utility approach, and J.R. Hicks and Allen gave the theory of indifference curve approach. All right. So moving on, we have started the utility approach only. I have told you that this entire chapter is basically divided into two parts. In the first part, we will be discussing only regarding the utility approach, and in the other part, we will be discussing about the indifference curve approach, which was given by J.R. Hicks and Allen. All right. So I have also told you that in order to understand the concept of consumer equilibrium through utility approach, you must understand the following five concepts. You must understand the meaning of utility, total utility, marginal utility, law of diminishing marginal utility, and utility of money. If you do not understand these topics, you won't be able to understand the meaning of consumer equilibrium as per utility approach, as per the theory given by Professor Alfred Marshall. If you want to understand the concept of consumer equilibrium through his approach, through Alfred Marshall, you must understand the following basic concepts of equilibrium. So basically, overall, there are five things that we must understood before proceeding or before understanding the meaning of consumer equilibrium. And I think I have explained you the meaning of utility, na? I have told you that utility is basically satisfying power of a commodity. Mazen, please pay attention. Actually, according to Alfred Marshall, Alfred Marshall basically said that a customer, whenever a customer uses or consumes any kind of commodity, that particular commodity gives him certain amount of satisfaction. Suppose if I'm thirsty and I drink a glass of water, that glass of water will provide me certain amount of satisfaction. The satisfaction which I'm deriving from consumption of water is considered as utility according to Alfred Marshall. Alfred Marshall basically says that satisfying power of a commodity is called utility. All right. And one more thing he said, that utility of a commodity can be expressed in numbers. Like if you have consumed water, then the amount of satisfaction that you have derived from the consumption of water, you can express, you can write this in terms of number. Suppose if I'm thirsty and I consume water and I got certain amount of satisfaction, and I am expressing the satisfaction by giving it 20 number. I'm saying that I have got 20 utils of satisfaction. All right. One more thing that he said, that utility can be measured in terms of utils. Just like everything that can be measured have a measuring unit. Like when we measure distance, when we measure weight, anything that we measure have a measuring unit. If we measure the distance, we will measure it in terms of kilometers or meters. If we measure the height, we will measure it in terms of feet or centimeters. Similarly, when we measure the satisfaction, we will measure in terms of utils. So if I say that I have consumed water and it is providing me certain amount of satisfaction, say 20 amount of satisfaction, I will say that it is providing me 20 utils of satisfaction. All right. One more thing he said, that utility of a commodity keeps on changing from person to person, time to time, and place to place. That basically means utility is very subjective. It depends upon person, time, and place. Basically, all in all, we can say that utility basically depends upon the need of the person. If a person needs a product very badly, he will get higher amount of satisfaction. If there is no need to consume the good, he will not get any amount of satisfaction. All right, moving on. Next is total utility. I have also explained that total amount of satisfaction that a customer derive from consumption of all the units of a commodity is called total utility. If suppose I have 3 apples and I have consumed all the apples, all the 3 apples, the amount of satisfaction that I will get after consuming all 3 units of the apple is called total satisfaction or total utility. On the other hand, marginal utility is something like when one extra unit of commodity is consumed, the amount of satisfaction that you will derive is known as marginal utility. If I consume one extra unit of commodity and if I get 5 utils of satisfaction by consuming one extra, then 5 will be treated as marginal utility. Now, in today's session, we will discuss the meaning of law of diminishing marginal utility. But before proceeding further, I just wanted to know if you guys have any doubt in any topic. Peer, Steve, Smeeksha, you want to ask anything?
No, sir.
All right. Then you will face a little difficulty in the topic because you have not attended my first session. So there is a possibility that you might not able to understand everything, but just in case, if you are having any problem or if you have any problem, just let me know. I will try to clear everything. All right, Mazen. Mazen, am I all?
Sure.
Okay. Okay. So we will in today's session, we will understand the meaning of law of diminishing marginal utility. See, let me first explain this on the notebook, then I will explain it on the PowerPoint. See, law of diminishing marginal utility. What is a law of diminishing marginal utility? Marginal utility, I'm writing as MU. See, law of diminishing marginal utility, basically, it simply states that, when a customer suppose this is customer Mr. X. When a customer consumes a particular commodity, suppose a customer is consuming a, all right. So what law of diminishing marginal utility basically says that when Mr. X consume burger, with every additional unit of burger, the amount of satisfaction that Mr. X will drive will keep on decreasing. Satisfaction will keep on decreasing as he consumes extra unit of burger. All right. As much as he continues to consume more units of the commodity, the amount of satisfaction will keep on declining. And there will be a situation when Mr. X will not be getting any amount of satisfaction. And eventually, after a point, if he still continues the consumption of the burger, in fact, he will be getting negative amount of satisfaction or dissatisfaction. Like, suppose these are the units of burger, and suppose this is the marginal utility or the satisfaction that he is driving from every additional unit of burger. When he consumes the first unit of burger, he gets, let's say he got 30 utils of satisfaction. All right. So basically, initially he was highly satisfied. He got 30 utils of satisfaction. Now, when he consumed second unit of commodity, he got only 20 utils of satisfaction. So his overall satisfaction, he got less amount of satisfaction this time. Next time, when he consumes third unit of the commodity, suppose he consumed third unit of burger, he only got 5 utils of satisfaction, which means that he is getting less amount of satisfaction every time. All right. And suppose he again consumed fourth unit of the commodity, fourth unit of burger. Now, because after eating 3 units of burger, he must be already full. So fourth unit of burger will not provide him any utility. He is not getting any utility from the fourth unit. So his overall satisfaction reaches to zero. His marginal utility reaches to zero. Hence, at the fourth unit, he is not getting any marginal utility from the commodity. But what happens next? He consumes the fifth unit of the burger as well. Now, suppose when he consumes the fifth unit of the burger, because at fourth unit, he is not getting any amount of satisfaction, tell me what will happen at the fifth unit. Is he going to receive the satisfaction or not? Will at fifth unit of the commodity, Mr. X will be getting any satisfaction? Yes or no? Please tell me. At fifth unit of burger, he will be getting the satisfaction? Answer is no. In fact, this time, his overall satisfaction goes in negative. Goes negative basically means that he starts having difficulty. Now he is having dissatisfaction. Getting my point? So this is what law of diminishing marginal utility states. Law of diminishing marginal utility says that if a customer keep on consuming the same commodity continuously, then the satisfaction will keep on decreasing with every extra unit. And there will be a situation when his overall satisfaction reaches to zero. And if he did not stop his consumption, then his overall utility will go in negative. All right. This is what law of diminishing marginal utility says. All right. So law of diminishing marginal utility is a very important concept in microeconomics, which is basically related to the consumption. It basically says that customer, when consumes the good, gets the satisfaction. There is no problem with that. But when a customer keep on consuming the same commodity every time, the amount of satisfaction that he will drive will keep on declining. You know the reason? Reason is simple. Reason is very simple. Reason is that when a customer consumes the good, the amount of satisfaction will decline because his overall need will decline. As he consume more unit, he will have less need. Initially, he is having high need because suppose he was hungry, so he was getting higher amount of satisfaction. But as he start consuming the commodity, now his hunger decreases. And because now he is not hungry, he is not in need of the good, he is getting less amount of satisfaction. So basically, as the consumer consume more units, he will receive less and less amount of satisfaction every time. This is called law of diminishing marginal utility. See, law of diminishing marginal utility, what is written here is, as a consumer consumes more of a commodity, the level of satisfaction that he derives from the consumption of each successive unit keep on diminishing. All right. So law of diminishing marginal utility says that if a customer consumes same commodity every time, the level of satisfaction will keep on declining. So we can understand the law of diminishing marginal utility through this illustration as well. See, in this illustration, I have taken an example that a consumer is suppose consuming glass of water. So when he consumes the first glass of water, he gets the satisfaction of 20 utils, right? Marginal utility is 20. Extra satisfaction is 20. But after consuming the first glass, his thirst must have been declined. So when he consumes the second glass, his overall satisfaction decreases to 12. All right. His overall satisfaction decreases. Now, when he consumes the third glass of water, His marginal satisfaction will reach to 8, and in the fourth glass of water, his marginal utility reaches to 2. Then at the fifth glass of water, his marginal utility is 0. And when he consumes the sixth glass of water, when he drinks the sixth glass of water, his additional satisfaction reaches to -3. You are getting this. You are able to understand this table or not?
Everybody. So his satisfaction level is increasing and then decreasing.
I'm not talking about the total utility part. I'm just referring to the marginal utility only.
Okay.
See, the marginal utility, I will explain this column as well. But first you understand this column, that as the customer consuming more number of glass, as he's drinking more glass of water, the satisfaction he's driving every time is decreasing. Initially, he was getting 20 satisfaction, then 12, then 8, then 2, and finally 0. And if he continues to consume more glass of water, then at the sixth glass of water, his marginal utility will become negative. Is this clear to all of you? Is this clear to all of you that law of diminishing marginal utility basically says that as a customer consumes more of the commodity, his overall satisfaction will decrease? Is it clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let me take one more example. And through this, I will explain you the effect on the total utility of the product. See, suppose a customer is consuming any product, say product X, any product, and these are the units he have consumed, and this is the additional satisfaction that he is getting. Now we will here calculate his total utility. All right. So what happens is, at first unit, when he consumes the first unit of product X, He got 30 utils of satisfaction. All right. Now, because he have got 30 utils of satisfaction at the first unit only, can you tell me what will be his total amount of satisfaction? If he has consumed only one good and he have got additional satisfaction of 30, then what will be the total amount, total utility? 30. You getting my point? Basically, if I have consumed only one unit of any product, then my marginal utility and total utility both will be equal. All right. What is total utility? Total utility basically the total amount of satisfaction by consuming any number of unit. So if I have consumed one unit only and I have got 30 utils of marginal satisfaction, then obviously my overall satisfaction will be 30 as well. Next, I have consumed second unit, and after second unit, I have received only 15 utils of extra satisfaction. Can you tell me, if I have got 15 utils of satisfaction from the second unit, what will be my total utility now? I have got 30 utils of total satisfaction first unit. I have received 15 extra at the second. So now overall satisfaction will be 45. We will simply add this value to this. We will add 15 to 30. Now, I have consumed the third unit of the commodity. And on the third unit, I have only got 5 utils of extra satisfaction. I have received only 5 extra satisfaction. Can you tell me what will be my total utility? What will be my total utility? If I have got only 5 extra from the third unit, then what will be my total satisfaction at the third?
50.
What I am doing, I am simply adding the marginal utility to the total utility. I have got 45 earlier. Now I have received 5 extra. Then I will add this 5 to 45. It will be 50. At fourth unit, I have got zero amount of satisfaction. I have not received any satisfaction. Then what will be my total? It will remain 50, sir. It was 50 because we have added 5. Now, if we add 0, it will remain 50. And I have also consumed fifth unit, but fifth unit is providing me satisfaction in negative terms. It is giving me 10 utils of negative satisfaction. So what will happen to my total utility? Total utility will start decreasing. It will goes down to 40 utils. Is it clear to all of you?
Yes.
So basically, if you are noticing, what are we doing to calculate total utility? We are simply adding every additional utility. We are adding every marginal utility to the value of total utility. Initially we have got 30. We wrote 30 here. Now, at second unit, we have received 15 extra utils of satisfaction. Then we have added 30. Sorry, we have added 15 to this 30. It became 45. At third unit, we have received 5 extra. Then we have added 5 to this 45. It became 50. Next time we have got no satisfaction, it remained 50. We have got minus 10. Then the total satisfaction declined to 40, reduced 10. And in the same way, on this slide, see how I have calculated the value of total utility. First, from the first glass of water, I was receiving 20 utils of satisfaction. So my total utility will be simply 20. But in the second glass of water, my marginal utility is 12. It means I have got 12 extra satisfaction. So what will be my total utility? It was 20. I have got 12 extra more. This time now, 20 plus 12 will be 32. At the third glass of water, marginal utility 8. So total utility will be 32 plus 8. It will be 40. In the fourth glass of water, marginal utility is 2. So we will add this 2 to this 40. It will become 42. At the fifth glass of water, I have got no marginal utility. So my total satisfaction it remains 42. Now, at the sixth glass of water, marginal utility is minus 3. So what will be my total utility? Sir, 42 minus 3, it will be 39. All of you, everyone, is everything clear?
Yes, sir.
So Samiksha, Mazin, and Steve, do you guys have any doubt?
No, sir.
So basically, let me repeat this one more time. I have told you that law of diminishing marginal utility is basically a a law which is related to the consumption. And according to law of diminishing marginal utility, as a consumer consumes more number of unit of a commodity, the amount of satisfaction that he will derive will keep on decreasing with every extra unit he will consume. And I think this is very much applicable to everything. Everything that we use or consume. Suppose if I am drinking a cup of coffee. So when the first cup of coffee is being offered to me, I will receive higher amount of satisfaction. But when the second cup of coffee will be offered, I will receive less amount of satisfaction. And my overall satisfaction will decline when I will consume the third glass of coffee. Third cup of coffee. All right. So, one more thing that I want to explain here is, now we will discuss about the assumptions of law of diminishing marginal utility. When we discuss law of diminishing marginal utility, we assume something. There are certain assumptions to this law. What are those assumptions? Number one, first assumption of law of diminishing marginal is that we assume that consumer consume the same commodity. Law of diminishing marginal utility will be applicable only if consumer consume the same commodity every time. All right. If a customer changes the commodity, the level of satisfaction might not decrease. All right. What does law of diminishing marginal utility says? It says that if a customer consumes the same commodity every time, the satisfaction level will decline. If a consumer is consuming burger every time, the amount of satisfaction he will be getting from the burger will keep on declining. But suppose instead of consuming the burger, if I start providing him suppose cold drink or a pizza or something else, so the satisfaction which was declining will start increasing. Getting my point? Basically, let's say suppose we are talking about one of you. Talk about Sameeksha. Suppose Sameeksha comes to me and Sameeksha asks for the water. Sameeksha is thirsty and I have given her a glass of water. And after drinking the glass of water, I ask Sameeksha that, Sameeksha, how much satisfaction you have got? So Sameeksha said that, sir, I have received, suppose she said that she have received 10 utils of satisfaction only. I said, all right, no problem. I have given a second glass of water. Now she is like, sir, I don't need a glass of water anymore because I am all full and my thirst has gone and I don't want to drink this water. But I have insisted, and Sameeksha, drink this glass of water. So what will happen with the second glass of water? Her overall satisfaction will definitely decline. If she was getting 10 utils of satisfaction initially, then she must be getting less amount of satisfaction this time. She will be getting only, let's say, she will be getting only 2 utils or 4 utils or 3 utils or 0 utils. There is a possibility of getting less amount of satisfaction. But what happens this time? She got higher amount of satisfaction. I have offered her second glass. Now, instead of there is decline in his overall satisfaction, Sameeksha's satisfaction increases. He have received 15 utils of satisfaction. You know why? Because in the second glass, I have given her a glass of juice. Instead of giving her a plain water, I gave her glass of juice. So what did I do? Basically, I have changed the commodity. If I have given her a glass of water second time as well, then her overall satisfaction would have declined definitely. But with the second unit, her overall satisfaction increases. You know why? Because I have changed the commodity. So when you changes the commodity, there is a possibility that law of diminishing marginal utility might not be applicable. Might not be applicable means basically that law of diminishing marginal utility says that utility will decline every time. But if you change the commodity, there is a possibility that overall satisfaction goes on increasing. Is it clear to everyone? Peer, Samiksha, Steve, Mazin.
Yes, sir.
You have got this assumption clear? Yes, okay, all right. Now, there is one more assumption that there must be a continuous consumption of the commodity. Continuous consumption. Continuous consumption basically means that there must be no time gap. There must not be unnecessary time gap, unusual time gap. If I offer you a particular commodity on a continuous basis, continuously basically means that you have consumed one unit, I have given you the other unit. You have consumed the other unit, then I have again given you the third unit. You have consumed the third unit, I have given you the fourth unit. This is called continuous consumption. All right. If a customer is consuming the commodity on a continuous basis, if he is consuming the commodity continuously, then only law of diminishing marginal utility will be applicable. Then only his overall satisfaction will decrease it. But if there is a, if there is too much time gap between the consumption, say for example, I'm offering Samiksha one glass of water in the morning, and I have asked Samiksha what is the amount of satisfaction you have received from consumption of the water, and she's saying that, sir, I have received 10 utils of satisfaction. All right, now I am offering her a glass of water again in the afternoon. Now there is a too much time gap between the consumption of two units. First unit, first glass of water she have consumed in the morning. Now I am offering her the second glass of water in the afternoon. So please tell me, is there a possibility that this time Samiksha will get less amount of satisfaction from the second glass of water? Samiksha, if I offer you the water in the afternoon, you will get less amount of satisfaction this time or more amount of satisfaction?
Less amount.
Less, sorry, you will be getting less amount of satisfaction
if I drink the same glass, right? Yeah,
if you have consumed the same glass of water, but you have consumed the glass of water, one glass of water in the morning. Now you are basically drinking the water in the afternoon. So I think because of too much time gap between the consumption of two commodities, I think you will now be more thirsty. You will feel thirsty now. If I provide you the second glass of water in the afternoon, you will be getting higher amount of satisfaction. I think so. Samiksha, is that true? In case of you, if I'll offer you the second glass of water, yes, in the afternoon, you will be getting less amount of satisfaction, no?
No, it will be more
satisfaction. Because there is too much time gap between the consumption of two units. Alright, so law of diminishing marginal utility will not be applicable in such a situation when a consumer is consuming commodity in the unusual time gap. It will be applicable only if consumer is consuming the commodity on a continuous basis, one after the other. Next assumption is that we have assumed that the utility of a commodity can be measured in terms of number. Utility can be measured or expressed in cardinal numbers. While understanding the law of diminishing marginal utility, what we do, we basically explain the concept of law of diminishing marginal utility by making table and diagrams. See, I have made a table like this. Now I have taken a table assuming that customer is basically consuming burger and he is getting basically this much amount of satisfaction. So I'm representing the amount of satisfaction in terms of numbers. So this is my assumption. This will be my assumption throughout the law of diminishing marginal utility, that the satisfaction from a commodity can be presented in terms of number. See, this is not realistic. Is it realistic? Do you do such thing in life? in practically do you do these kind of thing that whenever you consume goods or avail any kind of services, do you actually give number to the basically amount of satisfaction you have received? Answer is no. In real life, if you have ever visited McDonald's or KFC, when you consumed food there, have you ever tried giving satisfaction in terms of numbers? Answer is no. In reality, in real life, you do not do such a thing. But while studying the law of diminishing marginal utility, we assume that utility, that is satisfaction of a commodity, can be expressed in terms of numbers, 30, 25, then 0 and minus 10, values like this. So this is our third assumption. So first assumption was same commodity will be consumed, continuous consumption will be there, and utility can be measured in terms of number. And one more thing, we also assume that customer will consume the good in reasonable quantity. Reasonable, or let me say basically reasonable, we can also say that consumer must consume the good in standard size. See, everything has a standard size. Everything, or we basically, while understanding the concept of law of diminishing marginal utility, we presume that customer is consuming good in a standard size, a standard quantity. So what is a standard size? See, standard size differs from product to product. Let's suppose if I'm talking about coffee, right? If I say, if I'm saying that I will be offering Samiksha a cup of a coffee. So what basically you will be thinking of, you will basically be thinking of a cup of coffee, right? So for coffee, standard size is cup. If I offer you cold drink, so in case of cold drink, what is the standard size? The standard size is bottle or a can. All right. If I offer you tea, in case of tea, what is the standard size? The standard size is a cup of tea. If I offer you water, standard size is glass of water. If I offer you any fruit, orange, apple, mango, anything. So what picture comes to your mind? Picture comes to your mind is of complete apple, complete orange, or a complete mango, right? So basically, everything has a standard size. If you consume the good in a standard size, only then law of diminishing marginal utility will be applicable. If I offer you a glass of water, your overall satisfaction will keep on declining with every glass of water. But suppose if I offer you a spoon of water, if I start feeding you water with a spoon, suppose Samiksha is asking for water and I said, oh, okay, all right, no problem. I brought her a glass of water with a spoon in it. And I have asked Samiksha to drink the water with the use of spoon only. Please tell me, in that case also, with every spoon of water, her overall satisfaction will keep on declining. If she drinks the water using spoon, her overall satisfaction will decline with every spoon of water? Answer is no.
Yes, sir.
Why not this time?
Sir,
Sorry? I'm not able to understand.
No, like you're saying, with every spoon of water, satisfaction level will not decrease. How?
Because with a spoon of water, we will not be satisfied, no? Suppose we drink a spoon of water, all right? What does law of diminishing marginal utility says? It says that if you are getting, let's say, 50 utils of satisfaction from the first unit, then you will be getting less amount of satisfaction with the second, and less with the third, less with the fourth, less with the fifth, all right? But suppose if you are drinking the water using spoon, suppose you are very thirsty, and I have start giving you water through spoon. I said, Peer, open your mouth and I will put the water in your mouth. So with first spoon of water, will you be getting satisfaction? Yes or no? Answer is yes. I will be getting the satisfaction. But please tell me, if I put the second spoon of water in your mouth, you will be getting less amount of satisfaction this time. Answer is no. If you are consuming the water through spoon, it will take longer period of time before your satisfaction start decreasing. getting my point?
Yes,
if
sir.
You are consuming this water through spoon, your satisfaction will not decline with the second, third, fourth, or fifth spoon of water. It will take a lot of time. You know why this time law of diminishing marginal utility is not applicable? Because you are not drinking the water in a standard quantity, standard size. What is the standard size in case of water? What is the standard size? Glass of water is the standard. Cup of water or usually the glass of water is a standard size. So law of diminishing marginal utility will only be applicable if these assumptions are being followed. If a consumer consumes the same commodity every time, then only his satisfaction will decrease. If he keep on changing the commodity, his satisfaction might not decreases. Assumption is that consumption must be continuous. Consumer consumes the product continuously. Third assumption is that utility can be measured in terms of numbers, cardinal numbers. Fourth assumption is that we are assuming that consumer is consuming the commodity in a standard size or reasonable quantity. All right, everyone, please let me know if you have any doubt. Everything is clear to all of you. All the assumptions are clear. Meaning of law of diminishing marginal utility is also clear. Okay, if everything is clear, then we will do one more thing now. Let's try to understand the law of diminishing marginal utility one more time. And after this, we will be preparing a diagram based on our understanding. So please pay attention. This is going to be very important. So according to law of diminishing marginal utility, if a customer consumes the commodity, his marginal utility will keep on declining. I am also making a column for total utility. All right. So suppose he is consuming 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 units of the commodity. Initially, in the first unit, he was getting, let's say, 30 utils of satisfaction. And then he is getting, 20 utils of satisfaction, then 10 utils of satisfaction, then 5 utils of satisfaction, then 0, then minus 2, and then minus 10. All right. So basically, marginal utility is declining every time. This is what basically law of diminishing marginal utility also says. Now, what we will be doing, we will be calculating the value of total utility. So I think it is simple. I have already taught you how to calculate total utility. We will simply add the values of marginal utility. So first unit, marginal utility is 30, then total utility will also be 30. Always remember that at the first unit, marginal utility and total utility both are equals. Next, at the second unit, marginal utility is 20, then total utility will be 50. Then it will be 60, then 65, then 65, then 63, and finally 53. All right. Now what we will be doing, we will be making a diagram based on this table. So in order to make the diagram, what we will do, we will take two axes. First is the x-axis. Then there is y-axis. We will take the units on the y-axis and the value of marginal utility as well as total utility. Total utility, we will take this on the y-axis. All right, is it visible to everyone or do I have to zoom it?
Sir, it's visible.
Okay, thank you. So see, what is happening to the values of marginal utility? See, marginal utility is basically starting from 30, then it goes to 20, then 10, then 5, then 0, then minus 2, then minus 10. If you are able to observe the value of marginal utility, then you must be clear about this, that marginal utility is continuously declining. It has started from 30 and it goes to minus 10. And in between, it is continuously decreasing only. 30, 20, 10, 5, 0, minus 2, and then minus 10. All right. So if we make the diagrammatic presentation of marginal utility, how it will be presented on the diagram? If anything is decreasing continuously, how can we draw the diagram for such a variable? So basically, value of marginal utility is continuously declining. Let's suppose marginal utility is starting from this point. So this point onward, marginal utility will keep on declining. So if we make the diagrammatic representation of marginal utility curve, marginal utility curve will goes on decreasing. It will goes on declining. It will in fact intersect the x-axis and it will go beyond the below the x-axis. This is the marginal utility curve. Is it clear? Because marginal utility is continuously decreasing, so when we draw the marginal utility diagram, marginal utility curve will always be decreasing as well. And when the marginal utility is basically intersecting the x-axis, it is basically considered as that at this point, marginal utility is zero. This is the marginal utility zero. Suppose at this on the table, at fifth unit, marginal utility is zero. So this will be considered as the fifth unit when marginal utility is zero. All right, everyone. Steve is not there. What happened?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we will draw the diagram for total utility. Marginal utility was simple. It was throughout declining. So we basically made a downward sloping curve. It started from this point and it is basically declining throughout the various unit of the commodity. Now what will happen? In order to draw the total utility curve, you have to closely observe the behavior of total utility. See, total utility was 30 initially, then it goes to 50. Hence, total utility increases by 20 unit. After this, it increases to 60, then 65. Hence, till the fourth unit, if you are able to see this, you will see that total utility is increasing every time. Right? 30, 50, 60, then 65. Total utility is increasing every time. But once it reaches the fifth unit, total utility stops increasing. It remains constant. It was 65 at the fourth unit as well as it is 65 at the fifth unit as well. It was 65 on the fourth unit. It is 65 on the fifth unit as well. Hence, marginal utility initially increases, but after some time it becomes constant. It becomes stable. And after that, see, at this sixth unit, what is happening? What is happening to the value of total utility? Please answer. What is happening to the value of total utility? Value of total decreasing. Utility is increasing or decreasing?
Decreasing.
So basically, we can say that initially, total utility increases till the certain point. After that, it become constant and then it start decreasing. Now, if we have to make a diagram of this, we have to consider three things. Listen to me carefully. We have to consider that total utility will increase initially. Then we have to also indicate the constant part of the total utility. And then we have to indicate the declining part of the total utility. In case of marginal utility, it was simple because we only have to indicate that marginal utility is declining. So we made a straight line downward sloping curve. It was simple. But when you have to indicate the value of total utility or behavior of total utility through a diagram, how will you present that? What do? You basically make a diagram like this. See, starting point of marginal utility and total utility will remain same, because at first unit, marginal and total both are same. Okay. So when we make a diagram, we will start the value of total utility from this point only, because marginal utility and total utility both start from the same point. But difference, what is the difference? That total utility increases initially. It is basically going upward. So it is indicating that total utility is increasing. And it becomes constant after some time. All right. And after that, it starts to decline. This is total utility. Is it clear to everyone? What is the behavior of total utility? It increases initially, it becomes constant after some time, and then it starts declining. So basically, remember that in case of total utility, there are three stages: increasing stage, constant stage, and declining stage. So whenever you draw the total utility diagram, you have to keep that in mind. The total utility initially increases, it becomes constant, and then finally it starts declining. All right, everyone? Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Let me draw this diagram one more time for you, then we will end this session, and we will continue this part in the next class. So you must understand this diagram very carefully, because based on this diagram we will be covering the relationship between total utility and marginal utility. And this diagram is very important from the examination point of view as well. So you must be very clear about this diagram. All right. So let me explain this diagram one more time. What do we do while making the diagram? We take two axes. Number one is x axis. Then we take the y axis. All right. On the y axis, we take the values of marginal utility as well as total utility. We take both the values on the y axis. And on x axis, we only indicate the value of units, quantity. And how we draw the diagram, we first start with the marginal utility, because we know that marginal utility will always decline. So we simply make a straight line downward sloping curve indicating the value of marginal utility. And now what will happen to the total utility? How can we draw the diagram for total utility? What do? We simply draw an upward going curve, then we make it constant, and then we decreases it. But remember that while drawing the total utility curve, always remember that this part is not perfectly linear. This is a little concave. This is a curve shaped. Basically, this is concave shape. See, I am not making the total utility curve like this. I'm not drawing it like this. It is going like this, then constant, then decrease. I'm not making the total utility curve like this. Basically, always remember that total utility curve initially increases, but its shape will be a little concave. It will be a concave shaped curve like this. It is a concave shaped curve. Are you guys able to see this now? Everyone, you are getting this. I'm trying to say that initially total utility obviously increases, but in order to draw the diagram, you always keep that in mind, that whenever total utility increases, it will not be a straight line curve. It will be a little concave curve. And once after a certain point, you have to indicate that it is getting constant, and after that it is declining. All right. So in today's session, basically, we were discussing the law of diminishing marginal utility, where I have basically explained what is the meaning of law of diminishing marginal utility. And I have told you that law of diminishing marginal utility is basically a law related to the consumption, which is said that if a customer keep on consuming the same commodity every time, then the amount of satisfaction he will be getting with every extra unit will be declining. All right. And it might reaches to a level when the overall satisfaction or marginal utility becomes zero, and it may also become negative. But For law of diminishing marginal utility, there are certain assumptions. How many assumptions were there? Anyone? You guys remember how many assumptions I have told you? There were, I think there were five assumptions. Four. Number one.
Four
assumptions. Number one was, what was the first assumption? First assumption was that there will be no change same in the commodity. It will, it must same be the commodity. Same commodity. Second was, what is second?
Continuous consumption.
There must be continuous consumption. Number three, utility can be presented in terms of numbers only.
Cardinal numbers,
right? And then the fourth assumption is that
reasonable quantity.
Reasonable or standard size of consumption must be there. And on the basis of law of diminishing marginal utility, we have also learned that how can we make the diagram for the marginal utility and total utility. Please remember the concepts that I have explained you in this class. We will continue the law of diminishing marginal utility from this point in the next class. All right, everyone. So this is it for microeconomics in today's session. We will be starting the accountancy part in few minutes. So stay connected. I'll be joining you in after around 5 minutes. So take a break of 5 minutes, then we will continue doing accounts. All right, Mazin, you will be doing accounts as well.
Yes, sir.
All right, so stay connected. I'll be continuing the accountancy session in 5 minutes. All right.
Okay, sir.
Okay, stay tuned.